Governor Romney keeps talking about his experience at Bain Capital as a producer of jobs and that he had 25 years in the private sector. It seems to play with a certain group. But do you think that really will affect people and think that he can produce jobs that the president can't?
I think it will affect some people who relate well to businessmen. And I think he had a good business career. There's a lot of controversy about that, but just, if you go in and you try to save a failing company, and you and I have friends here who invest in companies, you can invest in a company, run up the debt, loot it, sell all the assets, and force all the people to lose their retirement and fire them. Or you can go into a company, have cutbacks, try to make it more productive with the purpose of saving it. And when you try, like anything else you try, you don't always succeed. Not every movie you made was a smash hit.
That's for sure.
So I don't think that we ought to get into the position where we say this is bad work. This is good work. I think, however, the real issue ought to be, what has Governor Romney advocated in the campaign that he will do as president? What has President Obama done, and what does he propose to do? How do these things stack up against each other? That's the most relevant thing. There's no question that in terms of getting up and going to the office and, you know, basically performing the essential functions of the office, a man who's been governor and had a sterling business career crosses the qualification threshold. But they have dramatically different proposals. And it's my opinion anyway that the Obama proposals and the Obama record would be far better for the American economy and most Americans than those that Governor Romney's laid out. That's what the election ought to be about.